Unicast routing protocols. A routing table that can be either static or dynamic. A static table is one with manual entries. A dynamic table is the one that is updated automatically when there is a change somewhere in the internet. A routing protocol is a combination of rules and procedures that lets the router in the internet inform each other of changes. Topic discussed in this section are optimization, intra and inter join routing, distance vector routing and RIP, link state routing and OSPF, path vector routing and BGP. Autonomous systems. This is an autonomous system. Here we are using the different four routers R1, R2, R3 and R4. Popular routing protocols. There are two different kinds of protocols, intra-domain and inter-domain. For intra-domains, we are using distance vector, that is RIP. Link state, we are using OSPF. And inter-domain, we are using path vector, that is BGP. Distance vector routing tables. So this is an example that shows the distance vector routing table. From A to B, distance are 5. B to E, distance are 3. And then C to U, distance are 4. And then C to B, distance are 4. A to C, distance are 2. And then A to D, distance are 3. So based on this, we have to call calculating the distance among the paths. Initialization of tables in distance vector routing. So this is the table. We have to find the distance from step by step. In distance vector routing, each node shares its routing table with its immediate neighbors periodically and when there is a change. Updating in distance vector routing received from C, A's modified table, that is compared with the A's old table, and finally we are forming the A's new table. And a two node instantly before failure. After failure, after A receives updates from B. 3 node instability before failure and after A, they sends the route to B and C, but the packet to C is lost here. This is the concept of the link state routing. In link state knowledge, A is states of links and B states of links here, C, D, E. States of links that are linked with a particular path. Here Dijkstra's algorithm start next set route to local node and move it to the tentative list. And in tentative list is empty, if it is yes, it stop, and then no means it will continues within the among nodes is tentative list, move the one with the shortest path to permanent list. Add such unprocessed neighbor of last moved node to tentative list if not already there. If neighbor is in the tentative list with larger cumulative cost, replace it with the new one. Example of formation of shortest path tree in the figure 1. Set route A and move A to the tentative list. B, move A to permanent list and add B, C to its tentative list. In C, move C to permanent and add E to the tentative list. For B, move D to the permanent list. Move B to the permanent list. 6, move E to the permanent list, that is tentative list is the empty. Routing table for node A. Node A, cost is 0, next node is nil. Node B, cost is 5, next router is nil. Node C, cost is 2, next router is nil. Node D, cost is 3, next router is nil. For node E, cost is 6, next router is
areas in an autonomous system. Area 1, here area border router. Area 2, area border router. Here we are using the backbone router also. A is the boundary router to reach the another AS, that is autonomous system.
types of links: point to point, transient, stub and virtual. These are the types of links. In point to point link, router, there are two routers that are connected. In between that we are using the point to point link. And transient link, figure A that represents the transient link, and B that represents the unrealistic representation, C that represents the realistic representation. Stub link, A is a stub link and B there is a representation. Examples of an AES and its graphical representation of OSPF. A that represents the autonomous system, B that represents the graphical representation. In initial routing tables in path vector routing, destinations A1, path AS1, like that for A1 to A5, the common path AS1 is used. In B1 table, for B1, B2, B3, B4, we are using the path AS2. For C1, C2, C3, we are using the path AS3. For D1, D2, D3, D4, we are using the path AS4. Stabilized tables for 3 autonomous systems, internal and external BGP sessions, internal external BGP systems, and right side is the internal BGP sessions. Multicast routing protocols. In these sections we discuss multicast and multicast routing protocols, unicasting, multicasting and broadcasting, and its applications. This is the unicasting. In unicasting, the router that forwards the received packet through only one of its interfaces. This is the diagram that represents the multicasting. In multicasting, the router may forward the received packet through several of its interfaces. Multicasting versus multiple unicasting. Multicasting and multiple unicasting. Emulation of multicasting through multiple unicasting is not efficient and may create long delays, particularly with the large group. In unicast routing, each router in the domain that has a table that defines a shortest path 3 to possible destinations. Shortest path 3 in unicast routing. In multicast routing, each involved a router that needs to construct a shortest path 3 for each group. In the source-based tree approach, each router needs to have one shortest path 3 for each group. In the group shared tree approach, only the core router which has a shortest path 3 for each group is involved in multicasting. Taxonomy of common multicast protocols: source based tree and group shared tree. For source based tree, MOSPF, DVMRP, PAMDM. Group shared tree, PAM, that is again classified into the PANDM and PAMSM, and then CBT. Multicast link state routing that uses the source based tree approach. Flooding broadcast packets but creates loops in the system. RPF eliminates the loop in the flooding process. This is the RPF, reverse path forwarding. And problem with RPF here, when consider this diagram, here net 3 that receives 2 copies of the packet. RPF versus RPF versus RPB. Here R1 is the parent of net 1 and net 2, R2 is the parent of net 3. RPB that creates shortest path broadcast tree from the source to each destination. Guarantees that each destination receives one and only one copy of the packet. This is the diagram. A that represents the RPF, B that represents the RPB, C RPM after pruning, D RPM after grafting. RPM adds pruning and grafting to RPB to create a multicast shortest path tree that supports dynamic membership changes. Group shared tree with renderer router. here shared tree number sorry a or ab here they are using the random bus router sending a multicast packet to the random bus router source shared tree black color that represents the unicasting and the blue color that represents the multicasting here. In CBT, the source sends the multicast packet that is encapsulated in the unicast packet to the core router. The core router that decapsulates the packet and forwards it into the all interested interfaces. PAMDM is used as a dense multicast environment such as a LAN. PAMDM uses RPF and pruning and grafting strategies to handle multicasting. However, it is independent of the underlying unicast protocol. PAMSM is used in a sparse multicast environment such as a WAN. PAMSM is similar to CBT but uses a simpler procedure. Here is the logical tunneling. Here we are using the four kinds of router for logical tunneling. And MBone, we are using the S source address, G that represents the multicast group address, R1 is the unicast source address, router R1, and router R2 is the unicast destination address.